Hello everyone, welcome to MESS e-learning channel. In today's tutorial, we are going to see another example on Sketcher workbench. So let's see what is the problem which we have. Okay, so now this is the sketch which we have to fully constrain with the help of dimensions as well as geometry. So in order to go to Sketcher workbench, the first thing we have to do is click on the new tab. In new, click on the part modeling workbench, select OK. Once I am into the part modeling workbench, if I have to go for any sketching, the first thing which you have to do is select a plane. So say I am selecting front plane as my sketching plane. Once you select it, click on the sketch icon. Okay, so now as we discussed in the previous tutorial, it's always easier to start a sketch with circles. So wherever you have any circular geometry in the entire sketch, you first begin with that. So it becomes easier to give dimensions as well as assign geometrical constraints. So now say we are beginning with this circle. So now this circle is concentric with the outer circle, which is having a radius of 36. So let us make both the circles and let this smaller circle having diameter of 23 is having the center point coincident with the origin of the sketch. Okay. So this is my first circle, right click, select to exit from it, go for the second circle. Now let us dimension both the circles. So the inner one is having a diameter of 23, the outer one is having a diameter of, it is given as 36, which will come out to 72. Okay, so now we are finished with both these two circles. Now let us look at the top portion. So before I go into the top portion, let us make a reference vertical line. Okay, so having made the reference vertical line, let's first make the horizontal line, which is passing through this vertical reference line. Okay. Now what I need to do is I will have to make both the points of this line symmetric with respect to this vertical line. So to make it symmetry, first thing is select the first point of the line segment, then press the control key, hold the control key, make sure you are holding the control key and select the end point of the line, followed by selection of the center line. Now you see the in add relations you can find symmetric, so click on symmetric. Now give dimensions to it. So right now the dimension which we have to assign to this horizontal line is 20 mm. Okay, so now what is the distance of this horizontal line with respect to the center, that is given to as 43. So go to smart dimension, select this line and the origin point, this will come out to be 43. So now let's go for creating this section. So what I will do initially, I will make a straight vertical line. Once I do that, now the creation of this arc is similar to the way we had followed in the first practice example. So now here the radius is 6. So what I will do, I will make a circle of diameter 12. Away from the sketch, so go to smart dimensions, give the dimension of 12. Once it is done, now what you have to do, you have to make this circle tangent to this circle as well as tangent to this line. So select this, press the control key, keep holding the control key and select this circle, go for tangent. Same, perform the same operation, make it tangent to this. Okay, so now we have got this arc. Now we have to trim the unwanted portion, so make use of power trim. So now it is complete. Let us also trim this and this. Okay, so now the same entity, this half, has to be repeated on the other side. So we can do it easily with the help of mirror command. Click on mirror, entities to mirror will be this vertical line as well as the arc. And we have to mirror it about this vertical line. Okay, so now this is complete, the top portion is complete, but we have to remove this because this is not seen in the sketch. So go to trim, power trim, remove these two entities. Okay. So, now let us focus on the bottom portion. So, at the bottom you see you also have a circle. So, we will just make a circle exactly beneath this circle, this one. Okay. So, again go for circle. So, here you can see it is having another two circles which are concentric, one is of radius 18 and the another one is of radius 36. Before we make this circle, we have to first see what is the distance of this point with respect to this. So, now since we can calculate it, this will be 158 is the total minus 43 minus 12. That is going to be the distance of this center with respect to this. So, before we go to circle, let us just extend this vertical reference line, okay, and let us make the two circles. So, inner circle is having a radius of 18, smart dimension, the diameter will come out to be 36. The outer one is having a radius of 36, so diameter will be 72. So, distance between both these circles will be, let us go for smart dimensions, select the center point of this circle and the center point of this circle. So, this will come out to be 158 minus 43 minus 12. We will do it again, that will be 158 minus 43 minus 12. Okay. So, now we have located this bottom two circles. If you observe the sketch properly, we only require the upper half of the circles. So, let us make a horizontal reference line, so that it will assist us in trimming the lower half. Now, go to trim, power trim, okay. Now, so we will first focus on this inner circle. So, after the semicircle we have to, let us make this portion. So, we have to make a vertical line. Now, this height is equal to 12. So, make a vertical line having a height of 12, smart dimensions, this will be 12. Then we have to, so what I will do, I will just randomly create this portion. Okay. So, now this has been given to us 15. So, before assigning this dimension, the total distance of this vertical and with respect to the center is 45. Go to smart dimensions, select this vertical line, center line, this will come out to be 45. Now, this one is 15 and this distance it is 4. Okay. So, now let us make this curve, which is having a radius of 8. So, this we will make similar to the curve by which we made the top portion. So, first we make a circle which will be having a radius of 8, that will be, it will be having a diameter of 16 away from this sketch. Then you have to go for tangency, select this circle, press control, select this outer circle, select tangent. Then again select this circle, press Ctrl, select this horizontal line, tangent. Okay, so now we will just remove the unwanted entities by trim entities. So we don't require this, and what I will do, I will go for trim to closest to remove this entity, else what will happen, it will also remove the reference horizontal line if I go for power trim, which will basically remove all the geometry constraints. Okay, so this portion is clear. Now let us go towards the left side. So here I will just make this much profile randomly. So we have a horizontal line followed by a vertical line, again horizontal, vertical. Okay. So now, so this distance of this vertical line from the center is 45. Smart dimensions, this one, this is 45. Okay. Now this one, this dimension is not given. This is given to as 15. Then this height is given to as, so 12 minus 9, this will come out to be 3. So let us give this, this will be 9. Okay. We will first fix this height, smart dimensions. This will be 12 and this one will be 9. Okay. So now we have to just remove this circle, trim entities, power trim, remove this and remove this. Okay. So the bottom portion is almost done. Now we are left out with this slot, which is an elliptical slot and followed by these inclined lines. So first let us go for this. So before we make this, let us make two inclined lines having an angle of 40 degree with respect to the reference line. So I will go for center line, just randomly incline it at a particular location. The angle will be 40. Same way we will make here also. Okay, now this we have to first make this center line curve, which is having a radius of 30 with respect to this center. So to make that, we have to use the 3-point arc. So select in arc, select 3-point arc. So starting point will be this, ending point will be this. And the third point will basically locate the actual location of the arc. Okay, so now this one will be 30. Okay, so we have to now just make it coincident with respect to the origin. So select this point, press Ctrl, select the origin. So make sure whenever you are going for assigning geometry constraint, the smart dimension is turned off. Select the center point, press Ctrl, origin. I will go for merge. Okay. Now just extend this. So now if you look, it is not a continuous center line which we are having, it is a center line type of arc. So I will select this and go for construction. Now we can create this entire profile with the help of 3-point arc slot. So go for select 3-point arc slot, this will be the first, second and the third point. So third point I am just bringing at the intersection of this reference line and this arc. Okay, and the fourth point will basically give me the overall width of this slot. Now they have given us the radius of 6, so this outer radius is 6, smart dimensions 6. Okay, so now this is clear, I guess. Now let us focus on the inclined lines. Before making inclined lines, we have to make a reference vertical line which is a distance of 18. So we need to make this where we can first make this curve. After making this curve, we will go for the inclined lines. So go to center line. Now this distance from the center line is 18. So now let us make a circle. Now it's a curve of 6, so let us make a circle of diameter 12 away from the actual geometry. Smart dimensions, this will be 12. Then select this circle, make it tangent to this, followed by selecting the circle and making it tangent to the vertical reference line. Okay, so now this is done. We will remove the unwanted entities, so we don't need this one. Okay, so now let us go for the inclined line. Okay, so before going to the inclined line, we will just I will just keep the entire circle, because we don't know where this inclined line is going to be tangent to the circle. Okay, so I will just keep the entire circle. Now just randomly make an inclined line. See, whenever you are making any entity, make sure it is not snapping. Snapping means whenever I am locating the end point of this line, you can see a blue projection. So that is basically it is getting snapped to some other constraint. So you have to select the second point in such a way that it is not snapping any of the constraints. So now, so at this location it is not snapping. Select this as the location for the second point of the line segment, right click, exit. Now, so I will select the line, press control, select the circle, tangent. I will just extend it so that we can make it tangent to this part. Select the line, press control, hold the control key and press this, select the circle, tangent. Now, we will go for trimming the unwanted areas. So this is not required, we don't require this, this, okay. So now this entire profile has to be repeated on the other side, which we can do easily with the help of mirror entities. Entities to mirror will be this one, the inclined line followed by the curve, mirror about this vertical line. Okay, so now we have to again remove some more entities. So go to trim, power trim. This one is not required. This entity is not required. Same way here also, we don't require this. Okay, so now, so yes, we are done with the complete sketch. So I will just maximize the screen. We will just see whether we are getting a fully defined. Yes, so it's fully defined, that means it is completely constrained. So then basically you can exit and go for a 3D modeling feature. So whenever you make any 3D model, make sure your first thing is to make it fully defined by assigning geometry as well as dimensional constraints. So I hope so the tutorials on Sketcher as well as the practice examples has cleared your concept on Sketcher workbench. So from the next tutorial onwards, we will be moving on to the part modeling workbench, wherein we will be learning the different features which are basically required to convert a sketch into 3D. Thank you.